तो लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड सिंप्लेक्स मेथड एंड वी हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड द पर्टिकुलर हाउ द प्रॉब्लम इज सॉल्वड. सिंप्लेक्स मेथड वी हैव स्टार्टेड एंड जस्ट वी हैव स्टार्टेड दैट हाउ द सिंप्लेक्स टेबल इज प्रिपेयर्ड, हाउ द पर्टिकुलर सिंप्लेक्स फॉर्म इज प्रिपेयर्ड, गिवन एग्जाम्पल इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू सिंप्लेक्स फॉर्म. So for that we have gone through these definitions of slack variables, then surplus variables, when to add a slack variable, when to minus the surplus variable, less than sign or less than equal to and greater than equal to. So that we have gone through. Then we have gone through these definitions, and then we have started. We have taken this particular simple problem, and this problem is converted into a simplex method problem. Is it right? And then we have, so today's task is we are going to solve this. Is it right? But taking this particular problem, already it is solved in this particular PPT. So instead of that, I will take another problem. So how to convert the simplex problem, simplex method, how to add this surplus variables and where to write in that table. Yesterday we have seen, is it right? Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? काल पर्यंत जेवढं झालं त्याला कोणाला डाउट आहे का? काय राकेश, एनी डाउट?
नो सर.
ओके, सो वी विल जस्ट टेक वन मोर अनदर प्रॉब्लेम दैट मे बी डिफरंट, सेम प्रॉब्लेम, अनदर प्रॉब्लेम बट स्टेप्स विल बी सेम. बट बिफोर गोइंग टू द प्रॉब्लेम I have to show you something that I will share another screen. Yeah. So I have to show you this particular I can say the flow chart of the particular simplex method. I have tried a lot to convert this into PPT, but I am not able to do this. I hope it is visible to everybody. Is it visible? This chart is visible. So I tried to put this particular I can call it as the flow chart into the PPTs, but I didn't found the right connection because this chart is little bit big. So what is there in this chart? So this is the, I can say this is the start where we can call it as the start of the your particular LPP model. So we have to what steps are there in this LPP programming. आपण जर एक्झाम्पल सोडवायला घेतलं तर आपल्याला किती इटरेशन पर्यंत सॉल्व करायचं आहे किंवा कुठल्या पॉइंटला थांबायचं आहे, वेअर वी हॅव टू स्टॉप, वेअर वी हॅव टू अंडरस्टँड दॅट अवर एक्झाम्पल इज कम्प्लिटली सॉल्व ऑर नॉट, दॅट इज एक्सप्लेन बाय दिस चार्ट. So in this first step is that express the LPP standard by introducing slack or surplus variables or artificial variables, assign CJ to them and objective function. So that is yesterday we have gone through. Then write initial simplex table and obtain the initial basic feasible solution. That is also we have seen. Then compute ZJ and CJ values. So yesterday we have gone through. The CJ values are upper side and ZJ values are at lower side. So compute these values means what to do. So compute means we have to make this calculation. So here it is written that CJ minus ZJ we have to make. CJ minus ZJ value we have to calculate. Then based on the problem, whether problem is of minimization or problem is of minimization, we have to decide what. If problem is of minimization, then select the key column with most negative CJ minus ZJ value. So why these steps are there? So when we are going for iterations, so CJ minus ZJ value we have to calculate, minimization problem CJ minus ZJ most negative value we have to find. If problem is of maximization, to select the key column and key row, so in that key column we have to use CJ minus ZJ positive value. Okay, so once this particular part is over, then we have to select key row. So yesterday we have not gone for this, the selection of key column and key row, etc. Yesterday we have just stopped here only, that write initial simplest table. So up to this stage only our part is over, is it right? So only this particular stage is over for our side yesterday. So what are the next part is there today we are going for? That, so we have to find the key column, then we have to find the key row, and so that is key row with minimum non-negative, so that will be the condition. Identify key element, okay, from key row and key, that intersection of key row and key column. Divide all elements by key row, make the key element one. So that step I will explain you with the help of example. Then again, at every point, we have to compute this Cj and Zj. That means Cj minus Zj. And where to stop? Why I am explaining this? Where we have to stop? If problem is of minimization, then Cj minus Zj should be greater than or equal to 0. Or if problem is of maximization, Cj minus Zj should be less than or equal to 0. So these two last condition we have to understand, and where this Cj minus Zj is coming less than or equal to 0 for maximization problem, that solution is we can call it as the optimal solution. Where Cj minus Zj is greater than or equal to 0 in minimization, that solution we have to consider as a optimal condition. Then we have to stop. Okay, then whatever this identification of key row and key column, how many times this iteration should be there? This iteration should be there for maximization problem. Cj minus Zj should be less than or equal to 0. That's why I have shown this particular chart. And in this chart, whatever the particular part is there, that identification of key row, key column, that I will explain you why it is required and how it is there. Okay. So we will go back to our PPTs and we will start one problem. So last lecture we have just started this particular point, but we have just converted this particular problem into the particular simplex method. So instead of taking this problem, let's take one more problem, little bit simple, because that problem having required to go for 4 iteration, and what is the problem I will take, it required only 2 iterations, so it will be little bit easy to understand you. So if you are writing with me, it's very easy. Okay, so this I will write here first objective function. Objective function. What is the objective function? That is nothing but our Z equation. So that Z equation is given already in the exam. Okay, so what is that objective function? Objective function is equal to Z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2. Then constant equation, that is shown like, or that is shown like, subjected to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 400. First equation, 2x1 plus x2 less than equal to 600. That's it. Two equations are there, and the non-negative condition is x1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So here this is our objective function OF. These are the constants, and this is the non-negative condition. Then what we have to do, we have to first convert this particular equation into simplex form. So here I will start the solution. First convert equations into simplex form. How that equation will be converted into simplex form? Can anyone tell me, Rakesh, how that equations will be converted? Which equation we should concentrate first? Shubham?
First equation.
That constant equation. That first equation is not like that. That constant equations. How the first equation, first constant equation will be converted? Can you tell me?
X1 plus X2 plus S1.
Yeah, correct.
Is equal to 400.
Is equal to 400. This is the first equation. Second equation. 2X1.
Plus X2 plus X2 is equal to 600.
Is equal to 600. Okay, correct. Then what that non-negativity condition will become? X1, X2, S1, S2. All are greater than or equal to 0. Is it right? Is it right?
Yes, sir.
And so these are called, we can call it as the constants. Then this is the non-negative. And what that objective function will become? How that equation will become? Z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2. Aya pudu kay anar
0s1
plus 0s1 plus
0s2.
0s2. Okay. So this given problem is converted into the simplex form right now. Then we have to prepare our yesterday's table. Okay. So I will prepare here yesterday's table. How that yesterday's table will be there? First, we have to write basic variables. So in if you look at last lecture, here three variables are there, S1, S2, and S3. And three equations are there. That's why the table is become little bit bigger. That's why I have taken simple example where only two equations will be there. So your table will be little bit smaller. Okay. So basic variables. Which are the basic variables? Can anybody tell me? Which are the basic variables? Rakesh, Shubham, which are the basic variables? X1, S2. Again? Shubham, only that much? Okay, what are the else? S1 and S2. Correct. So these four variables are there. So I will write here x1, x2, s1, s2. What is remaining else? What is remaining else? Apart from this, what is remaining else? What is remaining else? Rakesh, what is remaining to write in this table? What is remaining? What is remaining? Rakesh, B value. Correct. Correct, B value. I have to write B value. B value means equal to sign. So how my table will become, and above this table, above this, I have to write Cj. So I have to just go through this. So my first equation is x1, x2, s1 and 400. So I will write here s1 and s2 because these are the added variables. Is it right? S1 is presented in first equation. So 1, 1, 1, 0, 400. It is understood to you because what is my first equation? My first equation is x1 plus x2 plus s1 is equal to 400. And second equation, 2x1 plus x2 plus s2 is equal to 600. So where s2 is present? It is presented in second equation. So I will write here 2, 1, 0, 1 and 600. Is it right? Please reply faster. Is it right? Unmute and tell me, Shubham. Shubham, unmute yes, and sir. Tell me. Anyone, Rakesh, is it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I have to write the coefficient of z function. So what is the z function coefficient is there? Z function coefficients are 3x1 and 4x2. S1 and S2 are 0. So I will write here z function coefficient 3, 4, S1, 0, S2, 0. So that S1 and S2 coefficient of z function, I have to write here S1's coefficient in z function 0, S2's coefficient in z function 0. So this table is formed. Then my first condition is I have to go for ZJ calculation. Okay, how that ZJ calculation will be there? Yesterday I have told you how that ZJ will be there. Can anybody tell me? ZJ kasa kadayacha kal sangitlo hoto kasa kadayacha kon sangu shakte? Kon sangu shakte ka ZJ kasa kadayacha? First Rakesh, Shubham, unmute karan sanga patkarna. जर तुम्ही बोलला तर तुम्हाला जास्त समजलं एक्झाम्पल मध्ये. शुभम कसं काढायचं जडजे? राकेश, बी फास्ट. नो, सीजे मायनस जडजे इज नेक्स्ट पार्ट. फर्स्ट वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट जडजे व्हॅल्यू. हाऊ वी शुड कॅल्क्युलेट जडजे व्हॅल्यू? राकेश कसं काढायचं जडजे? How we should calculate ZJ value? Okay, just I will write here ZJ of x1. So x1. So this value 1 into this coefficient plus this value into this coefficient. So we have to take the column wise. That is 1 into 0 plus 2 into 0. How much it is becoming?
Zero.
For next column, how it will be there? ZJ of X2. How it will be there? 1 into 0. 1 kutla ghetla, tar ya column madla ek ghetla. Ani 0 kutla ghetla, tar coefficient jo ahe, to 0 ghetla. Gunile 0. Adik. Parat. Ek. गुणिले झिरो किती येणार? किती येणार? 1 गुणिले 0 अधिक 1 गुणिले 0 किती येणार? 0. परत इथं 1 गुणिले 0 अधिक 0 गुणिले 0 इथं पण 0. परत 1 गुणिले 0 अधिक 0 अधिक 0 सगळे मिळून 0 येणार. सो दिस इज द कॅल्क्युलेशन ऑफ झेडजे. ZJ कसं काढायचं पहिल्यांदा नीट लक्षात घ्या. वी हॅव टू अंडरस्टँड हाऊ टू कॅल्क्युलेट द ZJ, हाऊ दॅट ZJ शुड बी कॅल्क्युलेटेड, बिकॉज इच अँड एव्हरी स्टेज वी हॅव टू कॅल्क्युलेट दिस ZJ. अँड बेस्ड ऑन दिस CJ मायनस ZJ ओनली वी कॅन अंडरस्टँड वेदर आवर एक्झाम्पल इज कम्प्लिटेड ऑर नॉट. हाऊ टू कॅल्क्युलेट ZJ ऑफ X1, हाऊ इट शुड बी कॅल्क्युलेटेड दिस वन. Okay, just I will choose the different color. Okay, so this 1 into this 0, so 1 into 0, then we have to go for some addition plus, then again we have to go for different, that this 2 into this 0, that is 2 into 0. I have used the different colors, so which one I have taken and which 0 I have taken, which 2 I have taken, which 0 I have taken. So this summation is giving me the ZJ of X1. So that will be the 0. If I have to calculate the ZJ of X2, then I have to use again this 1 and this 0. So again I will use different color. Okay. this dark and again this zero. So concentration, that coefficient will be remain same. Plus, then I have to use this number one and this coefficient. So 1 into 0. So it will be coming 0. Have you understood? Shall we go ahead? Calculation of ZJ. Shall have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Shivani, okay. Nikita, Shubham, Rakesh, have you understood calculation of ZJ?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we have to go to the forward. That is, we have to calculate the particular CJ minus ZJ. This row we have to write. CJ minus ZJ. So what is the CJ value? CJ minus ZJ. What value will come here? Just tell me fast. CJ, what is the CJ value?
3 and 4.
3. No, we are just looking for this column only. For this column only, X1 column only we are looking. 3 minus, what is the value of ZJ?
0.
0. So how it is coming? How much it is coming? 3.
3.
For this column, for X2 column, 4 minus. 4. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
4 minus 0 is equal to 4. For S1?
0.
For 0. For S2?
0.
Okay. Then, so whatever, what we have looking to that particular flow chart, already I have shown you. In that, what is written? If CJ minus ZJ, if it is positive, then we have to go for further calculation. If it is negative, so what this particular problem is there? Whether this problem is of maximization or minimization, this problem is of maximization. Okay, so this is the objective function. So here, yes, I have not written, just I will write. This is the maximize Z. So this particular problem is of maximization. In the maximization condition, this CJ and ZJ value should be negative or 0. But here values are coming positive. So I will just rub this another part. So I'll just rub this part. Okay, just I will write the just the values. CJ minus ZJ. So 3 and 4. These values are coming. Then, what to do next? How to go for next iteration? So here we have to find out the maximum CJ minus ZJ value. Saglyat mutti CJ minus ZJ value kutli hai? Positive mutti. Kutli value hai sanga. Make it fast. CJ minus ZJ mutti value kutli hai? Make it fast, Rakesh. Shubham.
4.
Okay, so this 4 is, I just mark here like this way, two arrows. So this is my, I can call it as the, this is the particular key column. Okay, what is this? This is called as, sorry, key column. This is called as key column. Ya don, ya column madla, high element kiwa high element madla, key element asnar hai. Tar mala ata key element find out karayacha. The key element kasa find out karayacha? तर इथं मला थीटा कॅल्क्युलेट करावं लागेल. थीटाचं सूत्र काय? थीटा इज इक्वल टू बी डिवाइडेड बाय की कॉलम एलिमेंट. की कॉलम एलिमेंट. की कॉलम एलिमेंट कुठला आहे? तर हा आहे. इथं थीटा किती येणार? 400, दॅट इज बी व्हॅल्यू, डिवाइडेड बाय थीटा. थीटा की कॉलम मधला, ह्या रो मधला एलिमेंट किती येणार आहे इथं? 400 च्या रो मधला एलिमेंट किती येणार आहे इथं?
1.
सो 400 बाय 1, सो दॅट विल बी 400. अँड फॉर दिस रो थीटा विल बी 600 डिवायडेड बाय 1 इज इक्वल टू 600. 1 कुठने घेतला? तर हा 1 घेतला. बरोबर आहे का? बरोबर आहे.
येस सर.
आता या दोन्ही मध्ये म्हणजे कुठल्या दोन मध्ये 400 आणि 600 मध्ये मला मिनिमम नंबर पाहिजे, छोटा नंबर पाहिजे. दोन्ही मध्ये छोटा नंबर कोण आहे?
400.
हा माझा झाला की रो आणि हे झालं की कॉलम. की रो आणि की कॉलम. आता की रो आणि की कॉलम इंटरसेक्ट कुठं होते? की कॉलम आणि की रो इंटरसेक्ट कुठं होते?
ऍट नंबर वन.
ऍट नंबर वन इथं. बरोबर आहे? बरोबर आहे का?
येस सर.
ओके. इथं की रो आणि की कॉलम इंटरसेक्ट होते तर ह्याला म्हणायचं की एलिमेंट. की एलिमेंट. ई एल ई एम ई एन. ओके, की एलिमेंट. आता हा की एलिमेंट आला माझा. आता माझी नेक्स्ट स्टेप काय? तर की एलिमेंट माझा एक पाहिजे. एक म्हणजे युनिटी पाहिजे, एक पाहिजे. ऑलरेडी की एलिमेंट माझा एक आहे. बरोबर आहे? की एलिमेंट माझा एक आहे. बरोबर आहे? ओके. आता की एलिमेंटच्या खालचा म्हणजे त्या कॉलम मध्ये की एलिमेंट सोडून त्या कॉलम मध्ये सगळे झिरो पाहिजेत मला. मी काय सांगतोय? की एलिमेंटच्या कॉलम मध्ये मला झिरो पाहिजेत. म्हणजे ह्या एकच्या जागी मला काय पाहिजे? ह्या एकच्या जागी काय पाहिजे? झिरो पाहिजे. बरोबर आहे? म्हणजे आता आपल्याला काहीतरी रोजचं कॅल्क्युलेशन करावं लागणार आहे रोजचं. पण त्याच्या अगोदर एक लक्षात ठेवायचं आहे, आपण ही की रो आणि की एलिमेंट कशासाठी काढलं? की रो आणि की एलिमेंट कशासाठी काढलं? की रो आणि की कॉलम कशासाठी काढलं? फक्त की एलिमेंट हुडकायसाठी काढलं का? पटपटपट उत्तर द्या प्लीज, म्हणजे आपल्याला जरा पुढे जाता येईल. राकेश, फक्त की एलिमेंट हुडकायसाठी की रो आणि की कॉलम काढला का? हॅलो हॅलो राकेश.
येस सर.
हा, तेवढ्यासाठी तर नाही काढलेला आपण. तर आता नेक्स्ट कॉलम मध्ये काय करणार आहे मी? माझी किरो काय इंडिकेट करते मला? किरो कुठली आहे माझी? किरो कुठली आहे? किरो कुठली आहे?
400 सर. 400 रो.
400 ची रो. म्हणजे इथं कुठली येणार आहे? S1 ची रो येणार आहे. बरोबर आहे?
येस सर.
S1 ची रो. मी पुढच्या टेबल मध्ये S1 रिप्लेस करणार. कशान? X2 न रिप्लेस करणार का? तर इन द सिम्प्लेक्स मेथड की कॉलम इंडिकेट एंटरिंग एलिमेंट अँड की रो इंडिकेट लिव्हिंग एलिमेंट. म्हणजे काय असतं इथं? इथं लिहितो मी की एलिमेंट की रो इंडिकेट लिव्हिंग एलिमेंट किंवा लिव्हिंग व्हेरिएबल. नॉट एलिमेंट, लिव्हिंग व्हेरिएबल अँड की कॉलम इंडिकेट इट इंडिकेट एंट्रिंग व्हेरिएबल. म्हणजे आता काय होणार? मी ज्यावेळेस पुढचा टेबल लिहिणार त्या पुढच्या टेबल मध्ये मी S1 च्या जागी X2 लिहिणार. म्हणजे त्यानुसार माझे सगळे कॉलम आणि तुमचे जे काय आहे ते माझे सगळे हिशोब चेंज होणार. म्हणजे बेसिक व्हेरिएबल्स वगैरे थोडेफार त्या हिशोबानं चेंज होणार. कसे चेंज होणार आपण बघूयात. सो आय विल राईट हिअर वन्स अगेन द बेसिक व्हेरिएबल. ओके, सो बेसिक व्हेरिएबल्स. आपली रो आहे तीच राहणार आहे, त्यामध्ये काही सुद्धा चेंज होणार नाहीये. फॉर्मॅट आपला सेमच राहणार आहे. इथं आपलं काय येणार आहे? कोइफिशियंट ऑफ बेसिक व्हेरिएबल्स. बेसिक व्हेरिएबल आपले आहे तेच राहणार आहेत. X1 X2 S1 S2 आणि B. हे जे काय आपले नोटेशन्स आहेत, हा कॉलम ही रो कधीच बदलत नाही. इनिशियल रो जस्ट आता खालची रो बदलणार आहे आपली. आता काय होणार आहे इथं बघा, आपला टेबल तयार झाला. आता काय होणार आहे इथं, आता मी तुम्हाला काय म्हणलं की ह्या एस वन च्या जागी मी एस एक्स टू लिहिणार, म्हणजे काय होणार माझा बेसिक व्हेरिएबल इथं काय येणार एक्स टू आणि इथं एस टू आयतात राहणार आहे. का तर एस टू च्या रो मध्ये कुठेही मेन कॉलम आलेला नव्हता, की कॉलम किंवा की एलिमेंट कुठं आला होता तर पहिल्या रो मध्ये आला होता. त्यामुळं एस वन गेला, का एस वन गेला तर की रो एस वन मध्ये होती त्यामुळे एस वन गेला, आणि त्या जागी एक्स टू आला, का एक्स टू आला तर की कॉलम हा एक्स टू चा होता. ठीक आहे, हा फक्त इथं बदल झालेला आहे, एक्स टू आणि एस टू असं झालेलं आहे, बाकी सगळं तेच राहणार आहे. सी जे ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह फंक्शन माझं तेच आहे, 3 4 0 0 ह्या व्हॅल्यू माझ्या सेम राहणार आहे. आता एक्स टू चा कोइफिशियंट ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह फंक्शन मधला, म्हणजे एक्स टू चा सीजे मधला कोइफिशियंट किती आहे? हॅलो,
4.
हा, इथे मी 4 लिहिणार. आणि एस टू चा किती आहे कोइफिशियंट?
0 0.
म्हणजे इथे मी लिहिणार 0. तुम्हाला कळलं मी कुठला बदल कुठे केला? एक्स वन जाऊन मी फक्त काय केलं, काय केलं मी एस वन च्या जागी मी काय केलं, फक्त एस वन च्या जागी मी काय रिप्लेस केलं, एक्स वन च्या जागी काय रिप्लेस केलं, मेक इट फास्ट, एक्स वन च्या जागी काय रिप्लेस केलं,
एक्स टू
का रिप्लेस केलं मी तसं, तर अगोदरच्या कॅल्क्युलेशन मध्ये किंवा अगोदरच्या टेबल मध्ये हे इंडिकेट झालं होतं की की रो काय सांगते आपल्याला, इंडिकेट लिव्हिंग व्हेरिएबल, कुठलं व्हेरिएबल निघून जाणार आहे आपल्याला कशावरनं कळतं, की रोवरनं कळतं. आणि त्याच्या जागी कुठलं एलिमेंट येणार आहे किंवा कुठलं व्हेरिएबल येणार आहे ते आपल्याला कशानं कळतं, की कॉलमनं कळतं. तर की कॉलम काय म्हणतो, एक्स टू येणार आणि की रो काय म्हणती, एस वन जाणार. मग सेम मी तसं केलेलं इथं एक्स टू अँड एस वन ठेवलेलं आहे. आता त्याच्यानंतरची स्टेप, मला की एलिमेंट कुठं आलेला आहे आपला, की एलिमेंट कुठं आलेला आहे ह्या टेबलमध्ये, फर्स्ट की एलिमेंट कुठं आलेला आहे,
एक्स टू.
हा, की एलिमेंट कुठं आलेला आहे आपला, की एलिमेंट कुठं आहे, कुठल्या लोकेशनला आहे,
इन एक्स टू कॉलम,
एक्स टू कॉलम एस वन रो, बरोबर आहे का. मग इथं मला एक पाहिजे, मी तर ऑलरेडी जांभळा कलर दिलेला आहे, इथं मला एक पाहिजे, एक आहे का, कितली व्हॅल्यू एक आहे का,
येस सर
आहे. समजा इथं दोन असत तर काय करावं लागलं असतं मला एक आणायसाठी,
डिवाइड बाय टू,
कुणाला, फक्त या नंबरला का या पूर्ण रोला,
कम्प्लीट रो.
करेक्ट, तुम्ही मॅट्रिक्स पद्धत शिकलाय, रो आणि कॉलम. जर तुम्हाला एखादी गोष्ट करायची असेल, समजा इथं दोन असतं तर मला ह्या कम्प्लीट रो ला काय करावं लागलं असतं, दोन्ही डिवाइड करावं लागलं असतं, जेणेकरून माझा इथं एक येईल. पण आता मला तसं काय करायची गरज आहे का,
नो
का, तर ऑलरेडी माझा की एलिमेंट किती आहे,
वन,
एक आहे. आणि माझा की एलिमेंट मला किती पाहिजे, एकच पाहिजे. तर काय मी बदल करणार नाही, मी आहे तशी ही पुढची रो लिहून घेणार आहे तशी, म्हणजे काय, 1 1 1 0 400 आहे तशी रो मी इथे लिहून टाकणार, 1 1 1 0 400. आता ही झाली माझी पहिली रो. पण आता दुसऱ्या रो मध्ये मला काय करायचं आहे, मला इथं 0 आणायचा आहे, म्हणजे की एलिमेंटची खालचा जो बॉक्स आहे, हा बॉक्स इथं लाल आणि हिरवा कलर मिक्स झालेला आहे, तो मी आता इथं हिरवा कलर घेतो, हा कलर घेतो, चला हिरवा कलर, पूर्ण डार्क हिरवा केला, हा घेतला जो एक आहे हा एक मला काय करायचा आहे झिरो करायचा आहे तर मला काय करावं लागेल तो मला झिरो करायचा तर मला काय करावं लागेल कोणी सांगू शकते मला इथं झिरो आणायचंय तर काय करावं लागेल रो ऑपरेशन सेकंड इयर फर्स्ट इयरला तुम्ही शिकला असाल रो ऑपरेशन तर मला इथं झिरो आणायचंय तर काय करावं लागेल मेक इट फास्ट राकेश काय S2 का आता इथे S2 कुठे आहे रे बाळा S2 मायनस S1 नाही आपल्याला हे जर S2 किंवा S1 ला म्हणायचं नाही आता आपल्याला आपल्याला काय म्हणायचं आता रो मध्ये बोलायचं रो मध्ये शिवानी रो मध्ये बोलायचं रो मध्ये आपण हे सोडून द्यायचं आपल्या फक्त एवढाच एवढाच पॉईंट लक्षात ठेवायचा बघा इथून एवढाच एवढाच टेबल लक्षात ठेवायचा ते नोटिफिकेशन आपण विसरून जायचं आता एवढा मॅट्रिक्स तुमच्याकडे आहे तर मी काय करावं लागणार मला मग एवढ्या ग्रीन कलरचा मॅट्रिक लक्षात ठेवलं तिथं तर तुम्ही काय लिहावं लागणार S2 च्या ऐवजी मी काय म्हणणार की कितवी रो आहे रो कितवी आहे ती कितवी रो आहे
सेकंड रो
R2 मायनस
R1
शिवानी तुम्ही काय म्हणले होते चार बॉक्स मध्ये S2 मायनस S1 बरोबर आहे तुमचं पण तुम्ही काय म्हणताय की तुम्ही हे बेसिक व्हेरिएबल कन्सिडर केले मी बेसिक व्हेरिएबल नाही म्हणत मी काय म्हणतो ही माझी सेकंड रो आहे आणि ही माझी फर्स्ट रो आहे तर मी रो वाईज बोलणार R2 मायनस R1 जर मी केलं तर मला इथं झिरो मिळेल ह्यामध्ये R2 मायनस R1 जर लिहिलं तर यामध्ये बदल कुठल्या रो मध्ये होतो पहिल्या रो मध्ये होतो का दुसऱ्या रो मध्ये होतो
दुसऱ्या रो मध्ये
समजा मी जर असं लिहिलं असतं R1 मायनस R2 तर कुठल्या रो मध्ये बदल झाला असता
फर्स्ट रो
त्यामुळं तिथं जे तुम्ही फॉर्म्युला लिहिणार आहे तो फॉर्म्युला तुम्ही व्यवस्थित लिहिला पाहिजे म्हणजे काय तर आता हा फॉर्म्युला मी कुठं लिहिणार तर ह्या टेबल नंतर लिहिणार म्हणजे अगोदरच्या टेबलच्या आधी म्हणजे ज्यावेळेस मी इथे येणार तर मी इथं लिहिणार अगोदर तो फॉर्म्युला काय R2 मायनस R1 आता R2 मायनस R1 करायचंय मला R2 ची व्हॅल्यू किती आहे इथं दोन वजा एक किती आली एक नवीन व्हॅल्यू मी इथं लिहिली आता नवीन व्हॅल्यू सगळ्या मी ग्रीन कलर मध्ये लिहितो 1 आली नंतर 1 मायनस 1
झिरो
इथं 0 मायनस 1 S1 ची पण व्हॅल्यू लिहावी लागणार ना 0 मायनस 1 किती आली बरोबर आहे का हॅलो बरोबर आहे का ओके 0 मायनस 1 आणि S2 ची व्हॅल्यू किती आली S2 ची 1 मायनस 0 किती आली 1 मायनस 0
1
बी व्हॅल्यू पण मला चेंज करावं लागेल काय 600 मायनस 400 किती आली
200
सो दिस इज माय न्यू रो आता ही न्यू रो कशी आली ही न्यू रो कशी आली तर मी R2 मायनस R1 केल्यामुळं न्यू रो आलेली आहे R2 मायनस R1 केल्यामुळं ही न्यू रो आलेली आहे ही न्यू रो आलेली आहे आणि माझी ओरिजिनल नवीन रो का तशीच राहिली तर माझा ह्या कंडिशन मधला ह्या टेबल मध्ये जी काय माझा की एलिमेंट होता तो एक होता हा की एलिमेंट किती होता एक होता त्यामुळे माझी ही रो आहे तशीच राहिलेली आहे आता जुन्यामध्ये आता मी जुन्यासाठी मी हिरवा कलर वापरतो हा माझा की एलिमेंट होता की जो ऑलरेडी एक आहे आणि त्याच्या खालची व्हॅल्यू किती झालेली आहे आता त्याच्या खालची व्हॅल्यू किती झालेली आहे की एलिमेंटच्या खालची व्हॅल्यू किती झालेली आहे मेक इट फास्ट
झिरो
बरोबर आहे की एलिमेंट एक झालाय त्या खालची व्हॅल्यू झिरो झाली म्हणजे परत मी आता ZZ काढणार आता परत मी ZZ काढणार आता ZZ किती होते सांगा मला मेक इट फास्ट make it fast. आता जड़ी सांगा किती येतो किती येतो जड़चे कसा काढायचा जड़चे जड़चे ऑफ एक्स वन सांगा किती कसं काढणार तुम्ही आता जड़चे हॅलो कसं काढणार फास्ट मायनस दोन कसा आला जड़चे मायनस दोन शिवानी कसा आला सांगू शकाल शुभम
वन इंटू फोर प्लस झिरो इंटू वन
हाँ वन इंटू फोर प्लस झिरो इंटू वन म्हणजे कुठले हा फोर हा वन हा झिरो हा वन बरोबर आहे त्याची व्हॅल्यू किती आली
थ्री मायनस फोर मायनस वन
नाही ह्याची व्हॅल्यू किती आली
याची
या मल्टिप्लिकेशनची व्हॅल्यू किती आली
फोर फोर
फोर म्हणजे जेडजे किती आला इथं फोर आता जेडजे ऑफ एक्स टू एक्स टू चा जेडजे किती आला एक्स टू एक्स टू चा कसा परत एक गुणिले चार अधिक शून्य गुणिले शून्य एक गुणिले चार अधिक शून्य गुणिले शून्य त्याचा पण किती आला चार आला इथं चार इथं चार इथं शून्य बरोबर आहे का बरोबर आहे का हे
यस
ओके आता हे जेडजे झाल्यानंतर न मग आपल्याला जायचंय सीजे मायनस जेडजे सीजे मायनस जेडजे आता हिथं आपल्याला की वरचा सीजे आणि खालचा जेडजे कन्सिडर करायचा आहे आता सांगा मला सीजे मायनस जेडजे किती येतोय सीजे मायनस जेडजे किती येतोय मेक इट फास्ट सीजे मायनस जेडजे किती येतोय
मायनस वन
मायनस वन ओके झिरो नंतर
मायनस फोर
मायनस फोर करेक्ट आणि झिरो बरोबर आहे बरोबर आहे का
येस सर
ओके शुभम व्हॅल्यूज बरोबर आहेत राकेश व्हॅल्यूज बरोबर आहेत
येस सर
अविनाश ओके आता आपली कंडिशन काय सीजे मायनस जेडजे निगेटिव्ह किंवा झिरो आला की मॅक्सिमायझेशनचा प्रॉब्लेम स्टॉप करायचा बरोबर आहे का बरोबर आहे का
येस
सर आता पुढे जायचं का अजून आपण आपण प्रिव्हियस स्टेपला जी आपण की कॉलम काढला होता की कॉलम आयडेंटिफाय केला होता त्या की कॉलम मध्ये सीजे आणि जेडजे सीजे मायनस जेडजे ह्या व्हॅल्यू कशा होत्या पॉझिटिव्ह आणि झिरो वाल्या होत्या त्यातल्या त्यात आपण हायएस्ट नंबर ऑफ पॉझिटिव्ह नंबरचा हायएस्ट वाला नंबर की कॉलम म्हणून काढला होता बरोबर आहे की कॉलम काढल्यानंतर मग आपण की रो ला गेलतो की बी भागिले की एलिमेंट म्हणजे की कॉलम एलिमेंट की कॉलम मधला एलिमेंटनी बीला भागाकार करायचा मग की आपण की रो काढला होता म्हणजे आपल्याला पहिल्यांदा काय काढावा लागतो की कॉलम काढावा लागतो आता या कंडिशनला सीजे मायनस जेडजे ह्या व्हॅल्यू जर मायनस असतील आणि झिरो असतील तर आपल्याला इथं मोठा नंबर पॉझिटिव्ह नंबर हा मिळतोय का सीजे मायनस जेडजे सीजे मायनस जेडजे पॉझिटिव्ह नंबर मिळतोय का इथं मेक इट फास्ट प्लीज गिव्ह युअर आन्सर नो त्यामुळं या पॉइंटला किंवा फ्लोचार्टच्या पॉइंट नुसार वेन लाईक हिअर वेन सीजे मायनस जेडजे आर निगेटिव्ह ऑर झिरो स्टॉप स्टॉप फर्दर इटरेशन्स फर्दर कॅल्क्युलेशन्स ऑफ मॅक्सिमायझेशन प्रॉब्लेम ऑफ मॅक्सिमायझेशन प्रॉब्लेम इफ दीज व्हॅल्यूज आर पॉझिटिव्ह अँड झिरो देन मिनिमायझेशन प्रॉब्लेम शुड बी स्टॉप बट दीज व्हॅल्यूज आर निगेटिव्ह अँड झिरो इट कंटेन्स निगेटिव्ह अँड झिरो सो वी विल स्टॉप हियर अँड वी विल कॅल्क्युलेट द ZJ value, Z value. How to calculate Z value here? Can anybody tell me how to calculate Z value here? Simple. How you have calculated ZJ value for all the numbers? Same way for B column also, you have to calculate the Z value. How that you, we should calculate? So I will just write here formula. ZJ of B is equal to 400 into 4 plus 200 into 0. So this summation gives me 1600 plus 0 is equal to 1600. So that value I will write here 1600. And that is my Z value. So what will be my values in that case? Z max is equal to 1600. X1 and X2, these values I have to found. Whether in this basic variable side, in this column, X1 is present. X1 is present in this column. X1 ahe ka ita? No, correct. X1 ahe ka? Nahi. Munun X1 ji value ali 0. Ani X2 ji value. X2 ji value kiti yenar? Kon sangu shakal? X2 ji value kiti yenar?
4.
Four hundred.
Its coefficient is 4, sir.
Its coefficient is 4. I am asking value. I am not asking coefficient.
Okay, sir.
Now, what is the value of then X2? What will the value of X2?
400.
Where it is written? In the
In the column B,
correct. In the column B. So this 400 is the value of this X2. As for ZJ, I have taken the value of, for this ZJ, I have taken the value of 1600 from this B column. Similarly, for this X2, I will take the value of 400 from this B column. So X2 value will be 400. In this column, whether X1 is present? No, X1 is not present. Hence, X1's value will be 0. Then similarly, S1 is present in this column? S1 is present in this column? Hello, be fast. S1 is present in this column?
No.
No, then S1 value will be 0. And S2 is present in this column? Yes, S2 value is 200. Then once you got all these values, then we have to check whether these values are correct or not. S2 value will be 200. So I will go back to the problem. Okay, what is my problem? X1 plus X2 plus S1 is equal to 400. What is the value of X1? X1 value is 0. Is it right? This value you remember. X1 value 0. X2 value 400. S1 value 0. S2 value 200. And then we have to go here. So here S1 value 0 plus X2 value 400. Plus S1 value 0 is equal to 400. So my first condition is get satisfied. This condition is get satisfied. Second condition, 2x1, 2 into 0 plus 400 plus S2 value. S2 is 200. So this summation is coming as 600 is equal to 600. So second condition is get satisfied. Is it right? Then Z value. Z. 3 into 0 plus 4 into 400 plus 0 into, so this 0 is not having any effect. As their suffix is 0, I'll just write x1 and x2 value. So 0 into 4 into 400, so 600, 1600. So that should be the value of z. Whether that value is coming in my this particular table, whether these values are coming in this table, yes or no? Yes or no? Make it fast.
Yes.
Yes. So this is the, your problem is stopped here. That means this problem is given to you. This problem is given to you. And this problem, we have converted it to simplex method. We have solved this particular problem. And at last, we have got these values that x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 400, and z max is equal to 1600. So this problem is get solved. Where x1 plus x2 is greater than or equal to 400, and 2x plus x2 is less than or equal to 600. So these two constraints will be there. X1 and x2 are either 0 or positive values. And for this condition, we have to find maximum value of z. That is already we have found, and it is coming as 1600. Based on such a problems, your MCQ may be like this. How the key row is identified? How the key row is identified? Maximum number, maximum positive, minimum positive, maximum negative, minimum negative. What will be your answer? Anybody? What will be your answer? Maximum positive. No. Shubham, you lost mark. How the key row is found? That's why I have opened this particular page. Rakesh, what will be the key row? Rakesh?
Sir, minimum value of this.
Minimum positive. Minimum value of the positive. Yes, Shubham. Yes, correct. Minimum positive, Avinash. Not maximum positive. Minimum positive. And for key column, maximum positive. For key column, maximum positive. For key row, minimum positive. So like this, the questions may be asked. So simple question I have asked. Key row. How to identify key row? Your options will be first option, maximum positive. Maximum positive. Second option, minimum positive. Third option, maximum negative. And fourth option, minimum negative. I can use this particular option for key column also. How to identify key column? For key column, maximum positive. For key row, minimum positive. So like this, options may be same, but questions may be formed based on this particular examples will be like this. So this MCQ just now I have prepared. So such a MCQ may be asked for you in your exam. That's why if you are understood, no problem. If you are having any doubt, please ask me at this time only. Any doubt in these problems? Any doubt in this particular problem? Hello, any doubt in this particular problem? Okay. No, I am getting your response nicely. I am again little bit having confusion. So if you are having no doubt, let's start. We'll go for one more problem here. Shall we go for one more problem? Shall we go for one more problem? Okay. Okay, just I want to tell you the difference between these two problems only. Okay, so whatever this particular problem is there, whatever this particular problem is there, so just I will write this particular problem once again here. Maximize z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2 subject to x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 400 and 2x1 plus x2 is less than equal to 600. X1 and x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So this particular problem is given to us. This is we can call it as an objective function. This is the constraint and this is the non-negative. Okay. So if I want to tell you the difference between graphical method and simplex method right now. If you solve, already you are knowing what is the answer for this particular problem. Is it right? So already you are knowing that z value, that x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 400, and z max is equal to 1600. So already you are knowing these values by simplex method. But if as the problem is very very simple, by considering this, if you solve this particular problem by graphical method, how it look like, I want to show you, or how the your answers are different, that I want to tell you. Because if same problem if you solve by two different methods, your answer may be different. So x, so for graphical method, what I will do, x1 plus x2 is equal to 400. So that means x1 is equal to 400 and x2 is equal to 400. So just I will mark here. So this is my x1 graph axis. This is x2 axis. This is the 0. I'll just mark here 100. Then here 200. Then here 300. And then here 400. And at last, let's say 500. Or if I increase little bit, so 400, 500, let's say 600, and then 600. This side 100, 200, 300, 600. Okay. First point is 400, 400. So 400 and 400. This point will be here. So this side. Okay. This will be the lower side, means this side, less than. Okay, then x2 and x2 x1 plus x2 is equal to 600. How that will be there? X2 will become 600 and x1 value will become, x1 will become 300. So x1 will become 300 here and x2 will become 600 here. So I will join these two lines. Can anybody solve this particular problem immediately on notebook with pen and pencil and tell me the values? This is 300. So lower side of this area. That means if I will find out, I will get the common region as this. This much is the common region. So I will get the particular points as a, so I will call it as 0, 0, 0. This will be 400 point, that is A. Then this particular point, let's say it's B, and this particular point as a C. So Z 0, 0, 0. So 3x 3 into 0 plus 4 into 0, so 0 value will be there. At ZA, ZA, x1 is 0, x2 is 400. So 0 plus 4 into 400, that means 1600. B, ZB, so B point I have to find out. So I will draw one vertical line here, little bit 200, and this side it may be near about at 250. So 3 into 250 plus 4 into 200. So 750 plus 800. That will be 1550. And ZC is equal to 3 into 300 plus 0 into 4. So that will be 900. Into 300, that will be 900. So Z 0 is equal to 0, Z A 1600, Z B 1550, and Z C 900. So which value is coming it as a largest value? Which value is coming is as a largest value? Which value is coming as the largest value for Z? Can anybody tell me faster? Hello? Which value is coming is as a Z maximum? Rakesh, which value? ZA, correct. Which value is coming? Shivani? Rakesh? Yeah, ZA, and it is coming again 1600. And from our side, when we are using the simplex method, it is also coming it as 1600. So like this way, we can solve this simplex same problem by graphical method or by simplex method. So one problem I have solved with the help of simplex method also. And one problem we have, same problem we have solved with graphical method also. Is it right? So let's take one more problem. So this is our last lecture problem. Is it right? So I will just take that particular slide here, just a minute, and we'll go for it. Just this slide I will copy. Okay. This is the problem what we have started last lecture. So this is our last lecture equation, that is 4x plus 4x1 plus 5x2 plus s1 is equal to 1500. 5x1 plus 3x2 plus s3 is equal to 1575. X1 plus x2 plus s3 is equal to 420, and all are greater than 0. Z equation we have converted is equal to as 13x1 plus 11x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. So like this we have converted this equation. So let's talk about this equation. So this is the table. Okay, S1, S2, S3, Z values they have written. Okay, so we are not writing it minus, we are just writing it positively. Similarly, they have calculated the key element. Okay, so ZJ value. So coefficient of S1, S2, and S3, it will become zero by our way if we write here. Okay, so because S1 coefficient is zero, S2 coefficient is zero, S3 coefficient is zero. So ZJ, so I write here ZJ value. So here it becomes zero, it becoming zero, 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 everywhere it becoming zero. So CJ minus ZJ. So if we calculate CJ minus ZJ, then it becomes 13 minus 0, 13, and this will become 11. So maximum positive is this 13. So this will be the key column. Okay. So key column will be this. Then B value is written here. So 1500 divided by 404, 3075. 1575 divided by 5, 1315, and 420 divided by 1. It will be coming 420. So minimum value is this. Minimum positive. This is act as a key row. So this will be act as a key column. Sorry, key element. Key element. So this key element should become 1 and rest of the element should become 0. How to calculate? So here this key element become 1 and rest of the element become 0 by the what operations they have done. They have choose the most negative number, minimum ratio, and variable S2 depending on. So here what they have done, R2 divided by 5, this is the first condition, then R3 minus R2, so that this becomes 0, and last one, this. So R1 minus 4R2, so this will be change in the operations, these three operations. So this is becoming 1, these are becoming 0. Again, they have calculated the ZJ value, and based on that they have calculated. So again, it found that this is the, again, key element, this is the key row, and this is the key element. Here, what is there? So this key element indicate X1 is coming, and this key row indicate S2 is going out. S2 is going out. So same thing is happening here. Instead of S2, X1 is coming. So here what it indicate? It indicate X2 is coming and X3 is going out. So in next step, they have done same thing. X1 is already there. X2 is coming and S3 is going out. And after that, after solving, the last values will be X1 270, X2 75, and Z max 4335. That will be the ZJ value. So by though the representation method is a little bit different in the columns, but the method, whatever the procedure is there, it is same. Then one more is there. So here Z is having three values, X1, X2, and X3, and three variables are there. So in simplex method, how first variable is converted, can you tell me? Rakesh, how you convert this particular equation into simplex form? Shivani, Shubham, Nikita, how you convert this particular equation into simplex form? My voice is audible, no? Shubham, Rakesh, my voice is audible. Ah, hello, Rakesh. My voice is audible, no?
Yes, sir, audible.
Then nobody is replying. Okay, how this equation will be converted into simplex form? How this equation will be converted into simplex form? Rakesh, make it fast. Shivam, Shivani, please tell me how this equation will be converted into simplex form. Hello. How this equation will be converted into simplex form? Hello, Rakesh. How this equation will be converted into simplex form? Please faster. Make it reply. Make your reply faster. Shubham. Shivani, are you giving me answers or not? Okay, 2x, 2x1 plus 3x2 plus s1 is equal to 8. 2x2 plus 5x3 plus s2 is equal to 10. 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3 plus s3 is equal to 15. So like this way, you have to just add surplus variables. Sorry, slack variables in these equations. And then your z equation will become 3x1 plus 5x2 plus 4x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. So that will be goes on adding. And then we have to solve. So similarly, the equations will be 2x1 plus 3x1 plus s1, 2x2 plus 5x3 plus s2, 3x1 plus 2x2 plus 4x3 plus s3 is equal to 15. All are greater than 0. Okay. Then we have preparing the table. In this again, the three variables s1, s2, s3 are the three variables. Then their coefficients we are considering. Similar way, zj calculation. This particular number or element is found as key element. Then this x2 is entering, s1 is leaving. So this s1 is replaced in next table. X1 is leaving, x2 is re-entering. Again, next key element, next time key element will be this. So x3 is coming, s2 is going out. So like this, the things will be there. Last one, this particular key element is coming it as. So s3 is going and x1 is coming inside. So x2, x3, x1. When it is replaced, you will get x1 value, x2 value, x3 value, and z max value. So like this way, the method will be same. Again, this is the one more example in which the minus number is included. So again, it is the same way. So same way. How that same way is there? So this is we are converting into z. So 3x1 plus minus x2 plus 3x2 plus s1, 2x1 minus 2x1, 4x2 plus s2, and this equation. So here we are just adding the s1, s2, and s3. And then we are solving it. Similar, this is the key element. X2 is coming and s2 is going out. The same thing is replaced here. Then second time, x1 is coming, s1 is going out. So that is replaced here, x1, x2. And at the same time, you will get the optimal solution where x1, x2, x3, and z value or z dash value or z value is getting. So whatever the steps are there, these steps are very, very simple one. Okay. So this is again simple example. Can we solve this example? Okay, this example is again having minus signs. Okay, so how this example will be there? It is becoming like. It is becoming like x1 minus x2 plus s1 is equal to 1. Minus x1 plus x2 plus s2 is equal to 2. And here plus 0 s1 plus 0 s2. Is it right? But what happens in such examples, whenever there is a minus sign, we have to take proper care. We have to take proper care. Otherwise, there is a problem. So, sometimes the example is modified. Okay. So, how this example is modified? Okay. So, maximization problem is there. So, sometimes this maximization problem is converted into minimization. Okay. Sometimes that Z artificial variable is introduced. This is previously in the particular example. Right now it is not there, so we will not go for this example. We will try to solve it. Just a minute. Okay. So we'll try to solve this example, simple example. Okay. So just I will write here basic variables x1, x2, s1, s2, b. Okay. Then what will be the next step? Next step is finding S1, S2. Then CJ. What will be CJ? 3, 4, 0, 0. So 3, 4, 0, 0. What will be the next stage? Write down. 1 minus 1, 1, 1. 1 minus 1, 1, 0, 1. 0, 0. Coefficient of basic variables. The next equation, minus 1, 1, 2. Minus 1, 1, 0, 1, 2. So ZZ, what will be the ZZ? 0 into 0. Plus 0 into minus 1. So initially it is becoming 0, 0, 0, 0. So CJ minus ZJ is equal to 3, 4, 0, 0. Okay. So 4 is the larger number. So this is the particular key element, key column. Then key column I have to go for here. 1 divided by minus 1 is equal to minus 1. And 2 divided by 1. So 2. Which is the positive number? So this will be the positive number. This will be the key element. I am not considering here minus number. Okay. This is the key element. So x2 is replaced and s2 is going out and yes, x2 is coming in. So this is the one. No problem. I will use that one. But here I want to put 0. So R1 plus R2. So that operation I have to make here 0. So I will go to next basic variables x1, x2, s1, s2, b. Just I will make these all the columns. I will write. So who is going? S2 is going and X2 is coming. So here I will write X2. Here I will write S1. So CJ will be as it is. 3, 4, 0, 0. Then this particular column will remain as it is. Minus 1, 1, 0, 1 2 minus 1 1 0 1 2. This will be remain as it is, but here what will be here? R1 plus R2. So R2 value I have to add into the R1 column. So what will be the R1 value is already that I have to consider. So 1 plus minus 1. So it will become, it become 1 plus in bracket minus 1. So it will become 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So here it is becoming 0. Here it is becoming 0. Then here 1 plus, sorry, minus 1 plus 1. So it is becoming also 0. So here it is becoming 0. Then R1 1 plus 0, that is 1. Here 1. And here R1 0 plus 1, that is again 1. 0 plus 1, 1. And here R1 plus R2, 1 plus 2, that is becoming 3. Will become 3 here. So here coefficient will be changed 0, and here it coming 4. Here coefficient of B. Then ZZ. Calculation of ZZ. 0 and this minus 4. Minus 4. Then here it will be coming 4. Here it will be coming 0 and here it will be coming 4. So CJ minus ZZ. 3 minus minus 4, so 7, 0, 0, and minus 4. This is becoming positive. So this will be the key row first. Key row. Then I have to found the key column. I have to found key column. So how to find key column? 3 divided by this row, 0. So it become infinity. And 2 divided by minus 1. So this is becoming minus 2. So infinity and minus 2. Here which is the positive one? Infinity we can't predict, and minus 2 is predictable. So if I will multiply to these two rows with minus 1 and minus 1, this will be the, again infinity will remain here, it will become 2. So this will be my key column. But if I will put key column here, so x2 will be replaced by x1. That is not good sign. Is it right? That is not good sign. So instead of multiplying minus 1, I will keep as it is. So infinity may be positive. It may be 1 also. So I will select this as a key column. Key row. This will be the input. Again, here 0 is coming. So how to make it 1? Convert it into 1. It's very difficult. So such a problems we are not in position to solve. That's why we require to convert this problem into such a steps. What is this step? This is the modified step. So here we have to introduce the, we have to introduce some artificial variables. Auxiliary problems we have to prepare A1, A2. So your problem will become in form of A1 and A2, and then we can solve A1, it can be solved. So here your table will become X1, X2, instead of S1 and S2, it becomes A1 and A2, and then we have to able to solve this particular problem. And then at last, as table is maximum Z0, no artificial variable is available, so this particular table can be solved, and your answer will be like this: x1 2.5, x2 9.5, and z is 17.5. So some difficult or critical problems may be there in this, but before to going to this difficult or critical problems, once again we have to concentrate on the particular this Excel sheet. So if you are not having this Excel sheet with you, please write down it. Already whatever book I have shared in the particular our study material, in that it is there. So this particular Excel sheet or this particular flow chart explains you step by step process of the particular LPP problem. Express the LPP in the standard form by introducing slack or surplus variable. So slack variables, all of you are knowing how that slack variables is there. Okay, slack variables nothing but S1 and S2 and surplus variables or artificial variable that we have seen in the last problem. Then write initial simplex table to obtain initial. So initial table you are knowing. So what is that initial? Initial always zero is there. So compare ZJ and compute ZJ CJ minus ZJ value. So initially CJ minus ZJ value is always zero. That is we are knowing. Then based on the maximization, whether problem is of maximization or problem is of minimization, we have to follow the next step. That means what next step we have to follow? We have to, if problem is of minimization, then select key column with most negative CJ minus ZJ value. And if problem is of maximization, select key column with largest positive CJ minus ZJ value. That is, this particular condition is very, very important, which tells you how you can select the CJ minus, how you can select the key column based on CJ minus ZJ value. So if you are having notebook right now, please write down these particular formulas. Please write down these particular formulas. Select for minimization problem, select key column with most negative CJ minus ZJ value. For maximization problem, select key column with largest positive CJ minus ZJ value. Once you got the key column, then select key row with minimum non-negative, with minimum non-negative BJ minus AJ. BJ means B value and AJ means that key column value. So that we have to understand. If all ratios are negative or infinity, the current solution is unbounded. Stop the computation. So that will not be there. Once you identify the particular key row, then with the help of key column and key row, you have to identify key element. How to identify the key element? To identify the key element at the intersection of key row and key column. Where the intersection of key column and key row takes place, that is called key element. Then divide all the element by key row, by key column or key column element to get the modified new key row and next simplex table. So that is what we have to find out. The key element should be 1 and above and lower key element should be 0. Once you do this, then again next step is compute this CJ minus ZJ. Again, if minimization problem is there, then all CJ minus ZJ should be greater than or equal to 0. This particular condition is very, very important here. And for maximization problem, all CJ minus ZJ should be less than or equal to 0. If these two conditions get satisfied, your problem is optimal. So you have to stop there itself. But if no, then again, you have to go back to the select the key column and key row particular condition. So key column selection, again we have to start that particular process. So like this way, we can solve the simplex method problems.